I want to discuss the relationship between your friendly bacteria, your gut bacteria, we're going to call that microbiome, and your immune system. In fact, 70% of your immune system really is this microbiome, your gut bacteria. You have trillions and trillions of microbes living in and around your body that are constantly exchanging with you. You're giving them a place to live, and what they give you is immune protection. They give you nutrients, they help your blood sugars, and they give you other things that are beneficial. There's over 10,000 different species of friendly bacteria in and around your body. And 99% of them are non-pathogenic. They're the good guys. The great majority of microbes in your body are living in the large colon, just above and in the mucus layer. And then you have the colon cells, and then you have another layer of protection where you have certain immune cells or guards waiting for an invader to pop through so they can attack and eat them up. What happens is when you have an imbalance in the microbiome, you start to lose your gut lymphatic layer. You start to have a decrease in your lymph nodes. You start to have less antibodies. And antibodies are those things that attach on microbes. They don't kill the microbes. They put a tag on them for other immune cells to kill them. Antibodies are very specific to different pathogens. And then you also have a decrease in the T cell production. And T stands for thymus, because the thymus gland helps train the T cells. And you're going to have less of that. The primary function of the thymus gland is central tolerance, able to tolerate your own cells that are beneficial to you. Because if you did not have that function, these soldier cells, they're like special forces, would not be able to tell the difference between the good guys and the bad guys, and they would end up killing both of them, and you would end up with your own body cells getting attacked. That is a condition called an autoimmune disease. Autoantibodies are antibodies that are basically attacking your own tissue, but they're not really attacking. They're tagging your own tissue as being a bad guy, and other immune cells, like T cells, are going in there and actually trying to attack them, and that creates inflammation. And when you have autoimmune conditions, you always have inflammation, and that's really what's happening. You're getting this constant attack. And because the microbiome is so heavily connected to your immune system, when you lose this, you lose this, and you lose the tolerance, and you lose the ability to learn to differentiate. Now we have a situation where we have a lot of friendly fire, and we have a lot of collateral damage in the body and a lot of inflammation. T cells not only differentiate between your cells and a pathogen cell, it's quite amazing that your body has this ability to differentiate trillions of cells from pathogens that are not necessarily your cell, but they're so intimately involved and they're such a helper to your body that your body has developed a system to keep them alive and not attack and kill them. And also there are certain T cells that suppress inflammation. So if we lose that, what do we get? A lot of inflammatory conditions. If we also don't have enough microbiome, we get less small chain fatty acid, and one would be called butyrate. And butyrate is not only helpful in balancing your blood sugars and definitely improving insulin resistance, but it's also there to help improve your immune system. Also, you have less ability to make B12, B1, vitamin K, biotin, and even lactic acid, which makes the environment for pathogens very uncomfortable. Also, the microbiome are hoarding the food and the space to also limit the amount of pathogenic bacteria to exist. And the less microbiome you have, the weaker the intestinal barrier, and then you start getting leaky gut. And I really think, and this is my own opinion, that autoimmune disease starts in the gut. If you ever talk to someone who has an autoimmune disease, and I'm talking about like Hashimoto's, Crohn's, lupus, MS, they almost always have a gut problem. In my other videos, when I talk about COVID-19, the coronavirus, the way that that virus attacks your cell is through a receptor called the ACE2 receptor. Well, it just so happens that your gut has way more ACE2 receptors than the lung tissue. So this is another mode of entry into the cell that goes beyond just your lung infection, which is quite interesting. If you want to know what to do to support the microbiome, check out this video right here.